For this combustion reaction, CH3OH plus O2 yields CO2 plus H2O. Let's add up the atoms on each side of the equation. Carbons, we have one. Hydrogens, we have the three plus the one for a total of four hydrogens. Oxygens, we have one oxygen plus these two oxygens right here. So we have three of those. On the product side, carbon, we have the one. Let's do the hydrogens. We have two hydrogens. And then oxygens, we have two plus this one on the H2O for a total of three. Be careful, people often forget this oxygen here and it makes it very difficult to balance the equation. We can see that carbons are balanced, hydrogens close, and then the oxygens are balanced as well. So let's fix the hydrogens. We have two here. We want to have four so it can balance this. Put a two in front, two times two, that equals four. And you'd think you're almost balanced, but we've got to update our oxygens here because this two times the H2, but two is also multiplied by the oxygen. So let's update the oxygens. I have the two in the carbon dioxide plus the one times the two here. I have two there. So I have a total of four oxygens. So now things are a little more complicated because we have a four here and a three here. To solve this, let's figure out what we can multiply by this last oxygen by itself in order to balance all of the oxygens out. So I want to have four oxygens on this side here, so I'll change the coefficients to do that somehow. I have the one oxygen in the CH3OH. Let's leave that be. Let's work with this one. And then I have two here, and it needs to equal four. So the question is, what can I multiply by this two to give me three? And then the one plus three would give me four. If I multiply three over two times two, the twos cancel out, and I'm left with a three. So one plus three will give me four. And if I put my three over two in front of the oxygen, the equation's balanced. It's a little bit tricky down here, so let me just reiterate what I did. I looked and I saw that I had one oxygen here, and I didn't want to put a number in front of the CH3OH, so I just wrote one to account for this oxygen. And then I saw that I had two here, and I wanted to end up with four. So I figured out what I could multiply by two to give me the three. One plus three gives me the four. Some folks aren't comfortable with these fractions in their coefficients, so we can just multiply everything by two, and then that will take care of our fraction. So I'm going to put a two in front of the CH3OH, and I can multiply two times three over two. The twos cancel out. I'm left with this three here. I can put a two in front of the CO2, and then two times two. That would give me four. So now let's clean it up so it looks a little bit more presentable. And there you have it. That's the balanced equation for CH3OH plus O2 yields CO2 plus H2O. We have the coefficients of 2, 3, 2, 4. And again, when you leave the oxygen for last, that can make it quite easier to balance these equations. This is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.